Hi friends, here in this video we are going to see the derivation of torsional formula which would be required for solving the problems on torsion. So let's get started. First, I'll draw a diagram of a solid circular shaft. Now, here I have taken a solid circular shaft and these are the two views of that shaft. We can say that this is the front view and here is the side view. Now, when we are applying a torque over this shaft in the clockwise direction, so since the shaft is fixed at one end and free at the other end, there will be twisting in the shaft. And because of that twisting, if we take a point A on this shaft, because of the twisting, the point would shift to another location, and that location is A dash. So here this angle A dash is denoted as theta, which is called as the angle of twist. Now this angle of twist is assumed to be uniform throughout the length of the shaft. So I would be transferring this point A dash onto the other view. And this angle is phi, which is over the other view of this shaft. That is, here is the front view. The angle of twist is seen as theta, and over the side view, it is seen as phi. Now, the first part which I am starting here is getting the length of this arc AA dash. So since the length of this arc AA dash is radius into theta, since the radius is capital R multiplied by the angle of twist gives me AA dash. Next, by looking into the side view where I can see the length of the shaft, this AA dash distance could be found by applying the concept of trigonometry, that is using the relation of tan. Tan phi would give me opposite side by adjacent side. So therefore, opposite side is AA dash, adjacent side is L, and here since phi is a very very small angle, tan phi can be approximately taken equal to phi. So replacing tan phi with phi, it is equal to AA dash by L. Next, I'll put the value of AA dash from equation 1, that is R theta. So phi is R theta by L. Next, this phi is called as rate of shear strain, which is given by shear stress upon shear modulus, or also called as modulus of rigidity. And this relation is similar to the relation of strain, which is strain is equal to stress upon Young's modulus. So here we have shear stress upon shear modulus. So therefore phi is equal to theta by g, it is tau by g, which is shear stress. Next, I'll put this value of phi over here, so I'm getting it as Then here I am shifting the terms, so I get it as tau upon r is equal to g theta by l. And that will be equation A. Now tau upon r is equal to g theta by l. That is one part of the torsional equation. Now I am going to get the next part of this torsional equation. For that, I am again drawing the diagram of this circular shaft. Now inside this circular shaft, I am assuming a small ring at a radius of small r. And this ring is having thickness dr, its radius is small r. And the area of this small ring is small area dA. Now, how I am going to start this next part of the derivation is, considering an elemental ring at a radius of small r having thickness dr and area dA, next small amount of shear stress acting on the ring is given by, since from equation A I have the formula of shear stress, instead of capital R I am going to put small r, and that would give me the shear stress equation for this small ring. So tau would be g theta by l, and this capital R, in place of that we are going to have small r shifted over to the right side. So this much is the shear stress which is acting on this elemental ring. Next I am going to find the small amount of force, also called as shear force, which would be acting over this ring. So small amount of force acting on the ring, that would be df is equal to, since stress is force upon area, so force is stress into area, here we have tau as the shear stress, area is dA for the ring, therefore df will be equal to, instead of tau it is g theta by l into small r, and area is dA. So small amount of force acting on the ring. Now that force, I'll show it onto the diagram. Now suppose this small amount of force acts over here as a tangential force df, and because of this small amount of force there would be a torque produced, and that torque would be df into the radius, which is small r. Small amount of torque acting on the ring dt is df, force into radius. As per the definition of torque, it is the product of the tangential force multiplied by the radius of shaft. So therefore dt will be, I'll put the value of df, g theta by l into r into dA, and here radius. So it can be written as g theta by l, r into r will become r square dA. So this is the small amount of torque which is acting over the elemental ring. Now to get the total torque, I would be integrating this equation. So therefore integrating to get the total torque acting on the shaft of radius capital R. So therefore, integration of dt, and here we have g theta by L, which are the constant terms, integration of R square dA. So therefore, integration of dt would give us T, g theta by L, these are constant terms because the length of the shaft won't change. Similarly, material would be constant and angle of twist is constant. Now, integration R square dA, by definition, this is the second moment of area and it is also called as the polar moment of inertia. So instead of this integration term, I'll just write J, and since J is called as polar MI, which is polar moment of inertia, and by definition this J is equal to the integration of second moment of area, which is R square into dA. Then again, shifting the terms over here, so T by J is equal to G theta by L, and I'm keeping it as equation B. Now, equating A and B, in equation A, we had tau by R is equal to G theta by L. In equation B, it is T by J is equal to G theta by L. So when I equate A and B, I get the final equation as T by J is equal to tau by R is equal to G theta by L. Now, this is called as the torsional equation or torsional formula, which would be used throughout in the chapter of torsion.